Alright everyone, Buzz Killington back once more with another BuzzCast for your viewing pleasure. Both sides picked their factions, so I've opened with this player status screen like this. And you can see we have ConsistentlyBad, aka Doom Tiger, as his usual orange as Traveler 59, versus Accuracy123 as the blue-black hand. It's a smurf, I looked it up. It said not Encore, which makes me suspect it's Encore. But in case it's not, I'm going to call him Accuracy. Who the hell cares, to be honest? Wish people wouldn't smurf, but this is what you get. Anyway, Traveler, starting over here. Black Hand, starting down here, of course, because it is Tiberium Rift, not Tournament Rift. Both sides will start off going for their spike, as you would expect. Black Hand, they'll go for that. Traveler player also going for his spike straight away. We have a sail of the portals, so there is not going to be any kind of fast data descent rush. However, Accuracy, Encore slash not Encore, cannot afford to take that chance. Holding off there until his refinery is done. It is almost complete. So he is going to have to send, we have half a unit set up here. Half health scout there. That is now captured. We have a scout left here to stop it being recaptured, to being taken over, which is good. We have a buzzer scout coming around here. We have 1, 2, 3, as you can see on the map. This is good map. This is a good map for these. These colours really stand out. So he's sweeping the bottom. He should catch this buzzer scout. Ooh, the buzzer scout. Oh, I was going to say escape, but not quite. Black Hand Scout coming in here. A pretty good drop in here and put some mischief on this spike. Keep firing on it. Over here we have a full scout, full strength cabal squad. Spotted that seeker. Does a little bit of damage on the seeker, but not too much. In a fight between a seeker and a confessor cabal, the confessor cabal would win, which is quite entertaining. He has worked out from that. He hasn't even seen his base, but he knew from that he'd seen a seeker that quickly. There's no descent rush coming, so he's not too concerned about that. And indeed, he's gone into bike buggy. We have two bikes and a buggy, and not exactly an epic force. That'd be very useful for taking out that seeker, but I don't see where it is unless they've bagged that one already. No, in fact, they have not. They missed that seeker completely. He's going to have to build something to answer that. He knew it was there. But we have two bikes, but 1, 2, 3, 4 harvesters. But there is a seeker here. The seeker will be enough to destroy that. To be honest, it's not a great rush, because that's the best, I suppose that's the best way to call it. But yeah, two bikes and a buggy. They were never going to get anything done, really. The seeker escapes, despite the fact that nothing seems to have been built to kill it. But it will be tracked down, probably. It's only a matter of time. Here we are. The bikes and the buggy are probably going to intercept it and take it out now. Now that they know where it is, that seeker is dead. We'll watch this die as both team sides are expanding at the moment. Bikes fall back. No particular, well, they don't really need to stay there for that. The seeker scout is dead, but Jude saw what he needed to. He also saw no rushes coming in from Accuracy. Accuracy drops his MCV about here, which isn't great, because that gives him a radius to about here. Ideally, he wants to be here so he could drop his Tiberium Refinery right on the field, or just right up next to it. It's not much, but it saves a few extra seconds of turnaround for each harvester, and that adds up over time. Just something worth doing. And here we are. You can see Dune Tiger has deployed forward of the peak of the little bend there, rather than just behind it. So you can see his refinery is right down there where it needs to be. Wow, hello. Stealthy second war factory. I suppose it matters now. We have a second war factory out, but we have 1, 2, 3 seekers. But they're not going to survive this. We have bags of bikes and buggy, but Dune Tiger does not know that there's a second war factory as yet. This is pretty well hidden. He might suspect something if he comes around here and sees the MCV in this forward position. But he remains to be seen. Gunwalker here, but there's no buzzer squad attached to it. Eventually, this spike is going to die unless he does something about it. I believe he is repairing it. That's going to be some wasted resources over time. There we are. The buzzer squad has attached. That will now take out that scout. Spike buggy coming in, looking to do some damage, but there is a large secret force here already waiting to repel them. They can probably focus that down, but in the time it takes, more seekers are streaming south. They will intercept and deal with that. Accuracy decided he can't really get into there. In comes the Gunwalker. Is the Gunwalker going to come in? No, it's bugging out a bit. Oh no, it's bugged out. It's bugged out, and the scout lives. Doesn't matter anyway, because the spike is now going to die. No, it's not. He's not committing to it. Just kill the spike, dude. Kill it. There we go. Badoosh. Down goes the spike. Eco damage for Doom Tiger. Right, he's being pulled about. He's forced on a defensive, which is not ideal for Traveler. They need to be the aggressive player. They need to be keeping the other one moving about. Look at this refinery placement. Jesus. You do not see refinery placement like this very often at all. It's south and west of that tip field are well and truly covered. Meanwhile, Doom Tiger is a little bit behind in eco now. He... I was going to say it's because he had to spend money on Seekers, but he's also going fast tech. Well, relatively fast tech. Are we going to see Mechapedes or Trippets? That's the real question. Probably Mechapedes is a better bet. Ooh, in that comes. There's the first Mechapede. Oh, but that's bad time. Nice, easy kill. The Seekers are well out of position. There's really nothing here to stop them. Oh, we do have some Scorp tanks. Tier 2 is down now for accuracy. Oh, rip to tier 3. Rip to the tier 3. Sold off. No more Mechapedes. This could actually be it for Doom Tiger. It's hard to see what he's going to do to come back from this. The Seekers are here causing damage. One Harvester is dead. A second Harvester falls. We do have a sufficient Scorp tank force to force them back now. Not reverse moving. Probably lost one there. Perhaps could have been saved. Some Seekers are now pushing in. Oh, a half to kill. Oh, Doom Tiger loses one now. It's the accuracy. Bikes are getting out there. This harvester will go down as well. There we go. Doom Tiger right on the back foot now. He's lost his tier 3. He's lost the harvesters. Two harvesters. Had to sell off stuff up here. This base is basically dead. He's got nothing that can hold this. Yeah, there's the sell-offs. This power plant will go down as well. He'll probably be building another one. There we go. Gonna sell that one off as well. Is that gonna put him on low power? Nope, he's got enough power to sustain him. But he really is on the back foot now. Hot shots on tier. He could probably get a tier 2. He could probably get a tier 2 if he goes for this. Ah, oh, that's just opportunity. Accuracy probably could have taken that tier 2 down. But in the meantime, we have Scorp Tank Force behind this. It has repulsed a small Seeker Patrol coming around south, looking to do some harvest damage, but instead it found a lot more than it could deal with. Yeah, he didn't reverse move them far enough, and now they're going to die. Well, this one might escape. Yeah, that's making a run for it. That will get out of there. Over here, the bike buggy is still playing about around here. We have Descents out, but they are slow. They are going to do absolutely nothing until the Fast Legs comes down. But even then, there are buggies out. But yeah, even so, Fast Legs is being researched. This is a terrible position for this. This is a terrible position for that. He could probably get in there and kill that if he wants to. But no, if he'd gone in through the north, he could have killed that and set him even further back. But he didn't have the opportunity there. Accuracy perhaps being a bit more tentative than he wants to be. There are opportunities here for more pressure on. Scorp tanks, I think, chased that Seeker too far. But yeah, the Descents now have their fast legs. You'll expect to see the Stasis Chamber sold off in a minute, unless we're going to see a switch into Shock Troops, which I would not expect. Oh, down goes the Catalyst Missile. Doom Tiger now even further behind. Okay, no Shock Troops, both portals sold off. We have a sufficient, decent sized force of Descents and Seekers now. This is going to be present a bit of issue. Does he have Dozer Blades? He does not have Dozer Blades. Where is Dozer Blades? They're not even being researched. Jesus. He's got Tib Cam. Has he sold off his tech? No, his tech's there. He does not have Dozer Blades. Does he have Tib Core? No, not yet. He absolutely needs Dozer Blades to deal with these. But since he can just run that straight over. Nice sell-off, but there's nothing there at the moment. Are we going to see a Seeker? Oh no, a couple of units falling over here. Oh, look at the size of this force. Brutally large Confessor Cabal force. You need to get right out of there right now. There's the upgrade. The upgrade is done. Now charge particle beam is done, and that will counter them quite nicely. Dune really is on the back foot now. He's got a nice disintegrate here, which has cleaned up Bike Buggy. One bike survives. I don't know why he's kept the stasis chamber around. Unless he's planning to go shock troops, there's really no need for it. Cultists won't benefit him at this point. Considering the size of the cost. That was brutal. That killed, that destroyed a lot of the tip he was relying upon as well. It's really hard to see how Dune's going to get back into this game. We have a decent sized force up here. Seeker bin left there. What is Accuracy doing? Accuracy needs to be expanding now. He has some tip left, but not much for much longer. Is that going to be a Redeemer Engineering facility? I suspect it is. Oh no, it's just a barracks. A hand of not even. Okay, at this point he wants to be expanding. Look at the side. I mean, he did overspend a bit there on Confessor Quarles, let's face it. He really didn't need that money. Pretty could have held him just with buggies, to be honest. Tech is back out for Dune. Off two refineries on a base, on a field that is almost out of tip. Not ideal. He does have tip up there. He might have to resort to long distance leeching before too long. A beacon has been placed by ConsistentlyBad. To be like, haha, yes, I look at your giant, ridiculous, oversized infantry force. This is a ridiculous amount of infantry, and one single Gunwalker is just absolutely dancing through them. And wow, this Gunwalker really is paying for itself right now. Squashy, squashy. Oh, he stopped moving it. Oh, there's so many more units he could kill. Is it bugged out? Why is he not moving it? He literally, this is a bit of a waste of phase, defense. He literally phased one Gunwalker. But we have Mechapedes out, Mechapodes out. They will scythe through the infantry with ridiculous ease. The support packs will be able to do much either. Oh, he's starting to move. Oh, the Gunwalker just dies. Dune is busy microing elsewhere. And he needs an answer now. He needs an answer for the Mechapedes. But the problem is, Dune can't build too many of them. Oh, hello. Prodigy galloping about like a horse crab monstrosity that it is. Bloated genius horse, what are you going to do? What damage is he going to do? I mean, he could like area mind control some of that, but eh. He wants to capture the MCV, really. Where is the MCV? Where is the MCV? There it is. Oh, if he could capture that, that would really turn the game around for Dune. What's going on over here? Just infantry standing on Tiberium, nothing very much. Where the hell has that prodigy gone? Bloody things. Bloody orange on this map, I can't see. It was galloping about like a disheveled horse. Anyway, it's expanded. He has expanded. Oh, cultists have caught. Oh, a sneaky flame tank got intercepted. This harvester's, oh dear, feeding harvesters there. Sneaky flame tank got caught, just sent in to kill some infantry. Pretty much all it could do. Where is that prodigy? That prodigy is looking for a chance to capture that MCV, but Accuracy is not going to let that happen. But in the meantime, the Mechapedes are trawling in through here, and there's really nothing here to stop this. That's one upgraded power plant down. He's going to trash the rest of the base here. He could rake around here, trash a lot of this as well. The infantry is relocating, but the infantry is just not what you need against Mechapedes like Shard Mechapedes. There are some nice ranking up going to be going on for the Mechapedes now. Really Accuracy should sell this entire summon base and deprive them of the resources, of the XP even. Seeker's coming in for a little look-see. Where is that prodigy? I can't find the fucker. It didn't die. I know it's galloping about somewhere. No, he's building descents. Prodigy was dead, he'd be building it out again. Right, bikes and buggies there. Seeker there. MCV is still there. Alright, Mechapedes are roaming about. Oh, he's got the mobility now. Dune is back in the driving seat. Accuracy, let him recover. having a good look-see at everything that's going on down here. Bit of bike buggy came in for a probe. Excuse me for the coughing. The synths are here to repulse it. I have more infantry standing on Tiberian. Not exactly optimal there. Mecha P is just creaming everything that comes and tries to face them. Accuracy doesn't have the right units. He doesn't have them bunched up to deal with this. Oh, the poor harvesters. There's another harvester here he can kill, which he probably will in a minute. There's one there. He could just destroy this entire base if he wants to. Oh, June stopped paying attention. June really stopped paying attention there. What distracted him? He got distracted with something going on down here, I think. He lost the Mecha P for no reason at all. Their harvester that was there is now dead. He should just take out this entire base. That's what he's here for. Oh, he's selling off everything anyway. He should sell off those two as well. There you go. War Factory is probably going to go in a second. Nope, June's leaving it alive for some reason, but look at the size of this infantry force. Okay, MCV is exposed. That's not a good place. That's not good. Where is that prodigy? Why is there infantry all the way over here? Why is everything over here? That is not where you want it to be. Mechapedes are now cutting round. That MCV is super vulnerable. I want to see where the prodigy is. Oh, it's driving me mad. Maybe he actually did lose and he has to rebuild it, but back here we have bikes. Excuse me. Phase to save one harvester, bit of a waste of phase again, but three bikes, they're getting away there. No, we're just seeing, where is the prodigy? This MCV is super vulnerable. I don't understand what these units are all doing over here. Accuracy really needs to be guarding this MCV. He needs to get them over here now. This is a bad position anyway. Mechabee's over here. He knows this. A couple of bikes prattling about around here, but they're going to get killed. And they're not even going to kill that buzzer, because all they can do is shoot at where it was. Okay, he's realized he needs to move now. He's got a decent-sized infantry force, but it can be cut to pieces by Mechabee's. That's a problem. Even just 5 Megapedes kiting this can absolutely cut this force to pieces. What have we got coming out down here? Just a few descents though. If they just commit to that base, they could probably take it out. But in come the Megapedes. And the infantry is just absolutely getting shredded against them. Pulling back, this Scorpion tank is going to die. I don't know what happened to this one. It's a bit of a delayed reaction there. Oh, he mind-controlled them. Okay, he mind-controlled them. There is a prodigy out and about somewhere. He's got area mind control on them. Where is the bloody thing? There it is. Stay where I can see you, stupid horse thing. Right. Mechapede's just waiting for their chance. This base is super vulnerable. Just gallop to the north. Oh, fuck, it's gone. Bloody thing's gone again. There it is. Alright, that's convenient. Bloody thing's galloping to Dorf. He's looking for a way in. There is blatantly a way in. Uh-oh. Mechapi is coming in. And goodbye to basically everything alive inside that field. Oh, but is actually going to get Mechapi killed? No, the Mechapi strove right out of there. Good work. But in the meantime, while everything's delayed, some harvesters are going to die. Oh, he's switching targets. One harvester dies. Come on, this has got to be worth it. He's lost one Mechapede. He's lost the best part of a second Mechapede. Oh no, that hasn't really worked out very well at all for Dune. Okay, there's the MCV. It is completely undefended. And here comes galloping alien horse thing. Come on, horsey. And there we go. I've waited all game for that. And there it is. And that, folks, is GG. Oh, no, the War Factory lives. The War Factory lives. Dune needs to shred that War Factory now, and there'll be no MCV. Accuracy sat back too long. Should have got a Redeemer out. Should have pushed. But he didn't. Now he's going to lose his War Factory. And once that's done, done. That's GG. He's not even going to lose a Mecha Team to this. Watch this, because this is the end of Accuracy's game for sure. Wow. Okay, that's actually... He paid a hefty price for it. But that's it now. There was no need to drop that lightning spike. One Mechapede lives. Will it kill these two? No, it won't. Wow. That's some good shooting. He's taking out the Mechapedes, but the problem is... Oh, hello. What have we got here? We have Devastator Warships. He's been building them behind the lines. Behind the main advance, and now June has escaped in the bag. He is down to... one hand of Nod. That's it. And riding is on the wall for Accuracy, and indeed, he throws in the towel. So, what can you say about this game, really, folks, that I haven't already said? I mean, Accuracy had... so much the best of the early game. He had massive advantage. He kept consistently bad hemmed in, but as I say, there were chances that he didn't take when he could have, and he let June Tiger get back into the game, and once he did, he just rolled right over him. That MCV capture was sadly just only a matter of time. And yeah, Accuracy could have won, but he didn't push as hard when he could have. Probably should have shifted into Redeemer rather than spending the money on that, what's it called? Not Catalyst Missile. The Tip Vein, that's it. The Tip Vein. Rather than spending money on the Tip Vein, he should have got a Redeemer out. Sent it in, gone on full offensive. He could have taken anything that June Tiger had at that point. Yeah, he just clawed his way back into it, and you can just see... from the high point, Accuracy's troops just dwindling and dwindling and dwindling away. Good little game. Consistently Bad did have the best of it with his, once his Mechapedes got out, they really turned a tide for him there. Accuracy, surprisingly low kill death ratio, but he did do a lot of good work. He did keep him hemmed in, took a lot of harvests out. Unsurprisingly, Descent and Confessor Cabals, respective sides, favorite units. No great shocks there. Okay, that was a dice game. I enjoyed that one. That's a decent one. Glad I picked that. Hope you guys enjoyed it too. If you did, you know what to do. Like the video, subscribe to the channel, blah 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 blah. Most importantly, keep uploading replays. It's hard to find them. It really is. So it's making it a bit difficult. So keep them uploading them, and I won't have to cast bad ones, basically. Nobody wants me to do that. There are bad replays out there, I just don't want to cast them, but I will if there's no other choice. So save me from this and save yourselves. Alright, thanks for watching, and I'll catch you very soon for another BuzzCast.